Today we're going to take a look at using the Layers panel in Illustrator to manage objects that you've created in that environment. It's a very important feature, particularly when your drawings get highly complex. It's a great way of managing and structuring all your assets in the document. So stay tuned, we're going to take a look. Once you've created something in Illustrator, you need to be able to manage it. And a lot of that management of your assets happens here in the Layers panel. You make sure you go to Window, Workspace, and I'm just going to reset my Essentials Classic. That just resets your workspace back to its default starting position. And I typically like to use the Classic Workspace. The reason for that is there are a lot of videos that refer to older versions of the software, and so it just helps to keep things consistent. The Layers panel is found down here. I'm just going to tear it off. You can see it, and you'll notice that I've already got some layers in there. Now, when you create an object, I'm just going to use my ellipse tool here, and I've created an ellipse. It has what we call a stacking order. I'm going to create a second one. Oh, I'm going to use the selection tool, click on a blank area of the screen just to deselect this. And this will allow me to open my color panel, just choose a different color. And again, I'll use my ellipse tool and I'll create a second ellipse just right here. And you'll notice that the most recent object that's been created occupies a space higher in the stacking order. So you'll notice here in the Layers panel, I have a layer here, and I've got a little drill down triangle. So if I twirl that down, you'll notice that the green ellipse is on top of the orange ellipse. So if you imagine the viewer's eye being up here somewhere, you're looking from here down through the objects all the way to the back or to the artboard. So that's the way in which objects are created. Now, you don't have to create them in that manner. You have these features down here where you can draw behind or draw inside an object. So again, if I say draw behind, again, I'm going to use a keyboard shortcut, command click just to deselect. I'm going to choose another color. You'll notice now, if I have this object selected, well, let's have this object selected, and I go to draw another, you'll notice that it's drawing the object behind. So we can control that. Also, we have draw inside. So if we use draw inside and I go to create another object, and we'll give it another color. And you'll notice that it has drawn the light blue ellipse inside the area defined by that red circle. Just going to draw a new ellipse. And with that feature selected, draw inside. If I begin to draw another ellipse, we don't see anything because these things have the same coloration, but if I give it another color, you'll notice that that new ellipse has now been generated inside that blue ellipse. Just draw a little star, color that yellow, and you'll notice that it too is defined by that bounding edge of that ellipse. You'll notice here that we have two layers. And the way I like to explain that to my students is that think of these as being shelves. You know, like you open up the cupboard at home and you've got shelves and your objects are kind of like plates. You know, you've got dishes stacked on a shelf. So I'm just going to get rid of this top shelf here for now. I'm going to take a look at this one. Now you'll notice right off the top that you can hide a shelf or show it. Just by clicking here in the Layers panel, you can change the visibility. You can also lock a shelf down so that anything on that shelf is automatically frozen and cannot be selected. And you'll notice the pencil icon with the little circle with a slash through indicating that it cannot be edited. That's locking and showing a layer. Now I'm just going to unlock it. We can also open this up, kind of like opening up the cupboard, and we can look and we can see everything that's in that shelf. The topmost object here, you can see it's actually a group. I've created these plates out of multiple ellipses. And if we drill that down, you can see all of the elements in that group. And again, this also contains a special object that we can take a look at here, which was created using this tool over here called the Blend tool. We get to see all the objects. We can select all of the objects here in the Layers panel just by clicking in this fashion. So this is how we can select things. We can actually lock down individual objects so that this green plate cannot be selected. Everything else can be around it, but not the green plate. Again, we could lock several of these things down. So you'll notice that these ones cannot be selected down here. I'm clicking, but these ones can because they are unlocked. Now you'll also notice this little blue square over here in the far right. That indicates that there is an object that's selected. Now another thing that you can do is you can rearrange or restack the objects. So even though they're on this shelf, we can move the objects around and put that purple plate to the very bottom. And you notice now it appears behind that blue plate. In fact, if we move that around, you would notice that it's behind all of these objects and it would actually stack on the bottom. If you think of this by analogy, like cupboards in your home, you open the cupboard up, it's highly unlikely it's only going to have one shelf. And that's kind of what the layers are like. So we can create a new shelf or new layer down here. You'll notice that it automatically color codes each layer. You can set a layer up, give it a name by double clicking on it. And I'm just going to call this top shelf. And if we double click here, just off to the side, we can actually look at its options. We can actually hide a layer. Sometimes that can be useful if you've got printing information. We can allocate it as a template, we can lock it, we can even dim any images that are on that layer. So we have quite a lot of control over the layer, and we can also select from a whole range of colors, or we can even customize that color here in a color picker. This one I'm going to call bottom shelf, double click the name, and we can now move things between the shelves. So I'm just going to take these first three, and in order to select them, I could select them out here, either using a marquee or by clicking on each one and holding the shift key down. That's called the shift select method. Or I can go in here and click these little target icons and hold down the shift key in that fashion. So I've selected the first three and I can move those either by going Command X, click on that shelf, Command V. It's giving me a warning here indicating that top shelf is currently not showing. So I need to make that shelf actually show. Click on it, Command V, and you'll notice that these are now pasted in to this and it retains the layer structure. If I select this top purple plate, just by clicking the target icon, I can ask it to be sent right to the back. And I can also do that here, Object Arrange, and I can say Send Backward, or Command Left Bracket, or Send All the Way to the Back, Command Shift Left Bracket. Now you'll notice it sent it all the way to the back, but just to the back of the layer on which it's located. It did not send it all the way down. So the layering structure, it keeps the integrity of it within the layer to which it belongs. Now, if I want to move something between the layers, we saw the cut and paste method. We can also simply drag something from one shelf to another. And so now I've moved the purple plate down onto that other shelf. So we have this ability to migrate up and down within a layer. We can move things between layers, and as you've probably guessed by now, you can even rearrange the layers themselves. And there you have it. This is very important, particularly when you have highly complex drawings. With literally thousands of pieces, layers become very important to managing all of those assets and building them in a very structured way. So remember, we can hide them, we can lock them, we can open them up, we can reselect things from here, we can rearrange things from here, and of course, we can rearrange the orders of the layers themselves. There's one final thing. I'm just going to use the top shelf, open it up. You can create a sublayer. So it's kind of like a shelf within a shelf. And if we click on that, we've created a brand new layer. And I'm going to call that top shelf A. And we could arrange things on there. We can move things into that shelf. And we can drill down and we see the object there. And so we have this hierarchy or nesting of layers. Layers are kind of hierarchically connected, almost like a family tree. Oh, my challenge to you is I'm going to start variously hiding things, changing their stacking order. I'll be locking certain things. And it'll be up to you to do a little bit of sleuthing and figure out which things are locked, which things are hidden, and then to restack the plates on the same shelf in the order of the rainbow. So that's red, orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo, and violet. Okay, so your challenge is to stack the plates exactly like you see them here in this order. Of course, the file that I'm going to give you, called bowls.ai, is not going to look like this. So you're going to have to use your layers panel and what you've learned in this video to rearrange those in this particular stacking order. Good luck.